Hi, even though it is only early December, I still want to already air my grievances with King of Avalon. I have to say my interest was already going down lately. But the fact that this Kingdom versus Kingdom invasion season was again terminated early. That really frustrated me a lot, and together with the way they handled it and all the consequences of this this happening, this early termination. The thing is, I quite like this. In theory, I quite like this invasion season, and you can get some nice season rewards, and it is I find it nice that you're rewarded for actual participation, so occupying buildings, and you can get a total of, I think, is it like 75, 45, 60, 70, 75 celestials, so that is quite a lot. It does take quite some time, eh? You have 8 rounds, so that is 4 months, I think, right? Or 16 weeks at least, so that is quite a long period, but the 75 celestials extra is quite nice. And if you're actively participating and your kingdom doesn't at least some of the sessions, some of the Kingdom vs. Kingdoms can put up a fair fight, and you either make the full 8 hours or at least part of those hours, you should be able to get into that time bracket of 2401 minutes. That shouldn't be too big of a problem, I think. How many hours is that? Like 40 hours. So of the 8, if you can do 5 full, then you have your rewards. So that is quite, that's in theory quite nice. Now my first problem, well, let's say my first problem with this happening is that, again, they terminated early, and that is just a very annoying thing. You are in the middle or part of this season and they just terminated. I thought last time it was a choice, now it is due to some data error, they think. But either way, I think they made a very stupid mistake, or they just don't really think of the consequences. Second point is the compensation rewards that we get. They are, I got like initially 13 celestials. And also, I mean, we were just bumped into the C category last time, and we got our rewards based on the C category. While we haven't played any round in the C category, we were just bumped into the C category, and we got our rewards. So not the war scrolls, we got our rewards based on the C category. So just few celestials and intensity crystals and those resources, which I also find very strange. But the main thing is like 13 celestials, what is that all about? I was really looking at spending a lot of time in buildings, helping defend, helping conquer other kingdoms, so we're really doing our best, and then you get 13 celestials, which would imply that you have done less than 1/5 of the season, which I'm quite sure we did more, but I'm not exactly sure how long the season was at the time, if it was also 8 rounds and how many rounds we already completed. But it just feels like a very limited reward, and they can actually, because of a mistake on their side, you would think they compensate extra. I complained about it, as I'm sure many did, and quite soon it was swallowed by a second pack of 13 celestials. Still not very happy with that, but then my second problem came. My third problem actually, to realization, is that they gave people who never participate in, never occupy a building, they just get their own points, they give them the same compensation. Those people don't have any occupied minutes. Somebody told me that he got 2 compensation packs as well, and then I checked in one of my farms account that I sometimes use to get some points. Sometimes, like today, when we have very strong opposition, I reinforced a farm to get some points. And what happened, that farm also never was in any building, and it still got those 2 compensation packs for the season rewards. I think, what is that all about? Some people are putting in their time and effort to actively help the kingdom defend their Avalon or capture another Avalon, they are the ones who should get the season rewards, and others shouldn't get it, because that is what it is based on, the occupation minutes. But what happens? No, okay, we give it out to everyone. Everyone, probably everyone who scored some point during the early terminated invasion season, which I find, that I also find ridiculous. Why do I do any effort? Oh, they want me to hit them, so they're going to scout my tower, but okay, I already have my points. Okay, another problem, I think the fourth or something that I have with it, we start over this season and we have again this problem of a mismatch. So this is kind of a lost kingdom versus kingdom for our kingdom. You can say, okay, we could have done more. I don't know, I wasn't online at the start. Is somebody trying to... Oh, still my... earlier I was congratulating someone on getting their stronghold 47. Okay, maybe we're also not doing everything perfect as the... as in our kingdom, no problem, of course, but we had a very strong opposition, and basically it's lost kingdom. We have one player stronghold 48. That's our strongest player. One of the two kingdoms we are up against, they are currently holding all the three kingdoms, has at least, from what I've seen when I wasn't on in the beginning, but when I came on, I saw in our kingdom, from that kingdom, a stronghold 50, stronghold 49, two stronghold 48s. I don't know whether those were the top, the only ones above 47, but they might have more, and probably they have great stats as well, so we were overwhelmed. They were holding both kingdoms. So basically, for us and the other kingdom, this is really not fun. And okay, if that happens at the first of a season and you really have 8 or 12 rounds of that season, okay, we can accept it. But if you terminate it early and then again start with this, then think, okay, just do an effort to already say, you know, we put these in the B category, these in the C category, these in the D category, so all have some rather equal opposition. This is maybe nice for those really top kingdoms. They can easily take three kingdoms, have a lot of rewards. Nice for our kingdom, and for the other kingdom, it is just very frustrating. I think I'm just going to pull just to be just to frustrate them, even though there were no troops in there. Okay, so that is another main issue I have with it. So if you look at it, what happened, I don't think I got the right amount of Celestials that I should have gotten, too few from the previous season that was early terminated. I'm missing out on the packs, at least one pack, and maybe we had multiple packs because we were going in the C category, and there we have a chance of getting more than one kingdom. I'm missing out on those. I'm missing out on the fun of a equally matched kingdom versus kingdom, because it's not just about the packs, of course. It is about... I still find a kingdom versus kingdom, if you have a good match, it is the nicest event that there is for King of Avalon, but that is also wasted this time because of this restart. And combined with... that they just compensate everyone, even people who never occupy any building, they don't do anything for the kingdom from that point of view, and they get the same compensation. That is just just very frustrating for me. I'm not saying that I will quit the game right away, but let's say this further this further lessens the enjoyment I get out of the game and the commitment I want to do to actually do an effort for this game. So yeah, I'm quite frustrated. Just want to share that could be that there won't be any videos for a while. I'm sure others are frustrated. At least, especially the similar style players as myself, will be very frustrated with this early termination of the invasion season as well. And I guess I just felt like airing my grievances. Okay, well, that was it. If you want to air your own grievances or have any comments about mine, please feel free to share. And thanks for watching this video.